Hello everyone, welcome back. I hope all are doing very good at home. Stay home and stay safe. I'm going to discuss about the uses of, not only that, how to correct the usage of past progressive tense or past continuous tense in English language. Okay, so if we have to start discussing that particular tense, then we have to make use of, we have to understand what is the structure of this particular tense. So what is the structure? And it is simply like this. Okay, subject plus was or were plus ing form of the verb plus object if you are making use of the object in a sentence. Okay, so we know that this is the structure of each and every English sentence: subject, verb and object. Okay, and there are also, okay, sentences are possible with just S and V2, subject and verb with that too. Okay, well, so for example, if we consider this particular sentence, I was reading a book. Okay, I was reading a book. He was eating his dinner. She was playing. He was attending online classes. Okay, so all these sentences are examples of a past progressive tense in English. So let's see what is the rule. Okay, what is that agreement between the subject and the verb, because that is of too much importance. Okay, we know the structure as was or were plus ing form of the verb, but you know, there is a confusion among the students about whether to make use of was or were. Okay, so as you know, in all our sessions we repeatedly talk about the importance of subject. Okay, you should know how to identify, okay, the subject inside a particular sentence. What is the subject? Because depending upon the subject we make use of the verb. Okay, it's absolutely necessary. So over here, when a usual rule is this: with the singular subjects we make use of singular form of the verb, and with the plural subjects we make use of plural form of the verb. Okay, but coming over here, there is a very subtle difference. Over here, the structure is subject plus was or were and ing form of the verb. Am I correct? But here, when you make use of he, she, it, everybody, okay, plus plural subject I, these are the combination. Okay, with this subject combination, you can make use of was. Okay. He, she, it, everybody, boy, girl, okay, Andrews, Lalita, etc. Okay, all these are singular subjects. With that, you have to consider one plural subject over here, which is I. Okay, so with I and singular subject, you can make use of was when making use of the past progressive tense. Are you getting it? And so the rest goes with the were. So inside that particular key that we usually talk about, I, you, they, we, I has gone. Okay, when coming to past progressive, I literally went out of the group, and what is left is of course you, they, we, girls, boys, etc. Okay, all the plural subjects, and the plural subjects take were plus ing form of the verb. I hope that is clear. I just would like to add one very important idea. So we know that this was and were, these are the past form of is and are. Okay, so what you have to remember is these are the past form of the root word be, B-E-B. And was and were just have a difference in the spelling. But if you consider the meaning of was and were in Malayalam, both was and were have the same meaning. Okay, is and are meant aanu. Okay, and or aagunnu. Was and were actually means aayirunnu. Okay, aayirunnu. So it denotes a past thing. Okay, something that happened in the past. She was teaching. Aval padipichu kondirikkukayayirunnu. Just because was and were aayirunnu, ing form kondirikkukayayirunnu. Okay, that's how it actually comes. So remember that point too. Next, we will talk about the uses of this particular tense. So we know that this tense is actually used to represent an action which was going on in the past. Okay, so if I say I was having a dinner last night, okay, when he called me, okay, I'm just representing something that happened in the past. Anyway, moving on to this usage, the first usage is like this. Okay, we can talk about an action which was going on in the past at a point of time using this tense, past progressive. For example, at 11 o'clock, okay, I was sleeping. Are you getting it? At 11 o'clock, I was sleeping. I can also say I was reading. Okay, I was reading at 3 p.m. Are you getting it? I was reading at 3 p.m. Both sentences are possible. Then the next case is when you actually refer to two actions which are occurring simultaneously. If I say, when I was studying, my brother was watching television. When I was studying, my brother was watching television. So I'm actually referring to one particular point of time, okay, and at that point of time both of us are actually engaged in different actions, but at the same point of time. Are you getting it? When I was studying, my brother was watching television. And you have a tip over here, okay, when come to, you know, punctuation and all, you have to remember when you make use of when and while in a sentence. If the sentence starts with the when and while, you have to put a comma after the usage of that part of the sentence which has when. For example, in the sentence that we just have discussed, when I was studying, after that sentence, then you have to put a comma, then write my brother was watching television. Are you getting it? But if I literally make use of the same sentence in another fashion, for example, my brother was watching television when I was studying, then you needn't put any comma. Are you getting it? That is the key, that is the tip that you have to consider when you are making use of when and while. If the sentence starts with when and while, then you have to put a comma after the completion of that very statements. Okay, with when. It is a dependent clause. Okay, it is a dependent clause. After the completion of that dependent clause means it cannot stand independently. Okay, it has to depend upon the next part of the sentence to complete its meaning. After that, you have to, after the dependent clause, you have to put a comma. Okay, but if this when and while comes in between the sentence, you needn't go for, you know, putting any comma. Okay. So the next usage of this particular tense is, of course, you know, when there is a longer action that is going on, okay, that was going on, and you have an action which interrupted in between, a shorter action. For example, if I say I was waiting for the bus when I met her, okay, I was waiting for the bus when I met her. Over here, I was waiting for the bus, that was the longer action in progress at a particular point of time, and that shorter action is actually when I met her. That is why we make use of met. That combination actually takes simple past tense. Okay, remember when you make use of this particular tense. Another case that we usually use, okay, when we make use of polite request, I think you might have observed it, okay, you might have noticed it while watching movies and all. Okay, you can make a polite request like this. For example, I was wondering if I could get some help. Okay, I was wondering if I could get some help. Was wondering, that is of course a usage which comes inside this past progressive. Okay, and One another thing which is really really important about this particular tense is, of course, you know, we have a case called stative verbs and dynamic verbs. Okay, the stative verbs are actually the verbs which denotes thoughts, opinions, emotions and feelings, sensations and perceptions. So when making use of these kind of verbs, okay, which are in stative form, you shouldn't make use of this past progressive tense, because such verbs will never ever make use of a continuous form. Okay, for example, if I say very verbs like guess, know, mean, okay, like, dislike, love, hate, okay, and inside sensation and perception, of course, see, watch, smell, taste, okay, all this. While making use of these stative verbs, you should avoid making use of this past progressive tense. Okay, so if you say that you know, I was wanting to buy, okay, I was wanting to buy a laptop, that is an incorrect usage of the sentence. Instead, you just make use of the simple past tense. Okay, I wanted to. Okay, I wanted to buy a laptop. That is the correct and exact usage. Are you getting it? So I hope all the ideas that we have just discussed are pretty clear with you. Make use of all this information and share among your friends. Thank you. Keep watching. We will see next week.